Our story started on the water. I've always had a passion for sailing, and I knew that if I was going to spend the rest of my life with anyone, I'd want them to feel exactly the same way. A few years back, I decided to buy a boat, along with my dad and Andy, my best man. Yeah. We looked at quite a few boats and ended up buying one called Shadowfax. At the time, I didn't realise the significance of the move, but Shadowfax soon became the centre of our social world. After many, many, many years, we could just about keep up with the top boats. And one of those top boats was called Workout. Which just so happened to be sailed by Jeff.
Yes, I am the father of the bride. And what a bride. I knew Dave a little while before he met Rebecca. A bit unusual in itself. It was at a barbecue. We held a barbecue every year at Cowsley, and Hillary arrived. This is 5 days into Cowsley, and immediately said to me, "What's going on between Rebecca and Dave?" Most of you know me to be pretty observant, perceptive. You know, I normally have a good nose for these things. Well, I did have. Well, I said, "What do you mean?" Anyway, it seemed like I was the last to know. Something was afoot. It got completely over my head. I had very mixed emotions. They varied between angry and furious. My immediate thought was that he's trying to get one of my crew. He was after a new foredeck, and he'd seen the potential. Fearless Rebecca. Anyway, it was a couple of days later that I got a telephone call. Jeff, yeah? Dave. Oh, yeah. Just wanted to just touch on a few things. Just wanted to make sure you're sort of, well, some people would be, maybe wouldn't, but sort of cool about this. Yeah? He said, "Well, are you?" Pause. Long pause. I said, "Well, things could be worse. You could be an out-of-work drug dealer." Long pause. "Well, thank you very much." Last year, I got a call, and I think, were you up a mountain or about to go up one, or you were at the top of one? Anyway, it involved mountains. And it involved my daughter. And I must say, it was a fantastic call to get, and we were absolutely delighted. David, you know, asked us if we had any objections to him asking Rebecca to marry him. And we clearly had no objections at all. We were absolutely delighted. And well, the result of all that conversation is where we are today.
Good afternoon, everyone, and a warm welcome to the Abbey Church. A beautiful day and a perfect setting as we meet to celebrate the marriage of Rebecca and David.
I, David Anthony, take you, Rebecca Ellen, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death us do part, according to God's holy law. In the presence of God, I make this vow.
David, I receive this ring as a sign of our marriage. With my body, I honor you. All that I am, I give to you. And all that I have, I share with you. Within the love of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
So then, in the presence of God and before this congregation, David and Rebecca have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore proclaim that they are husband and wife. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
It was just over a year ago in the mountains in Chamonix that I asked Rebecca to marry me. But as nervous as I was asking Jeff for his daughter's hand in marriage, and as scary as it was actually making the proposal, the biggest mountain to climb was hoping that Bex's mother would accept me into the family. Well, I'm very... Perhaps I needn't have worried. As soon as we could, after we were engaged, we went round to visit Jeff and Hills. And Hillary quite literally came flying out of the front door with a huge grin, full of excitement for us. I felt like a climber summiting Everest. I'd finally made it past the Hillary step. And the rest, as they say, is history. Now, if Bex and I were the Romeo and Juliet of this story, then Shadow Facts and Workout were definitely the Capulets and the Montagues. There was an intense rivalry between us, and it was through this rivalry that Rebecca and I first met. But despite our competitiveness on the water, we realised that we actually had a lot of things in common. Bex and I have never really believed in the idea of opposites attract. Not only sailing, we both love skiing, we both love socialising, we both love food, travel, adventure. But probably most people would say our strongest character trait that we share is our incredible lack of punctuality. The past few years together have been a magical journey, and Rebecca and I have had some great adventures, some amazing times with family and friends. We've also enjoyed the simple things in life. There's been one thing that we've worked on together that I'm exceptionally proud of, and that's, as Jeff mentioned, starting the sailing charity we call Shadow Facts Racing. Named after Shadow Facts because of the good times and the good spirit that everyone had enjoyed on board over many, many years. And as with everything in life, Bex has really thrown herself into it. She's giving 100%, and it's been very special for me to work on such a great project with my future wife. I'm sorry, my wife.
It's with great relief and with huge, unbounded pleasure that on behalf of myself, Hillary, Robin and Liz, we'd like to welcome you to this event. As she came out of the house earlier and I saw her for the first time in her outfit, she fairly took my breath away. I actually didn't know what to do with myself. It was the most extraordinary moment, and no father could have been more proud. No father on this planet could have been more proud.
I feel incredibly lucky to finally be married to a woman who's so passionate, so caring, radiant, vivacious, and talented. And I think I know Bex feels the same. Oh. Well, I know how incredibly happy I am to be here today, marrying this wonderful young lady. Bex, what more can I say? Today, you've made me the happiest man in the world. You're not only my soulmate, you're also my best friend. I can't wait to spend the rest of my life with you.
Having shared a large part of the journey with Dave to reach this fantastic day, I'm so pleased to finally see him happily married to the wonderful, beautiful, and talented Rebecca Rolf. At this stage, it's traditional for the best man to offer some words of wisdom. And I'd like to paraphrase some advice Ronnie's dad gave to me when I got married. Married, and indeed family life, should be a continuation of the lives you and Bex have led so far. It's who you are and what has brought you together. Adapt and evolve, but stay true to yourselves, and above all, keep living your dreams. And now, ladies and gentlemen, all that remains for me to do is to please ask you to be upstanding and join me in toasting the new Mr. and Mrs. Rolf. Thank you very much.
Oh.